Kia ora, I'm Miriam McCummel. If you're dreading the birds and the bees conversation, chances are your kids have heard and seen it all before. Internet porn is teaching young people about sex. Much of it is graphic, violent and degrading. Tonight, Jahan Casanada investigates how this multi-billion dollar industry is getting Kiwi kids hooked. And a warning, this story does include sexual content.
It's a fantasy that you think has no consequences. You never get rejected by it. It's not watching you back.
Porn is not an educator. Porn is adult entertainment. And that's the problem.
It's free, fast, and fake.
I couldn't have a real relationship because I was developing this insidious relationship with the porn itself.
Internet porn is seducing young Kiwis, and I want to know why.
Action!
It's a journey that will take me into the heart of the industry.
So what you just did wasn't sex.
I wouldn't consider it sex, no.
And the heart of government.
How do you think people will feel about seeing these pictures?
I think they're going to be shocked. I'm shocked.
When I'm with you, I'm rich. Don't need no money, I'm rich.
James Wong is a Kiwi. But now he's more at home in Hollywood as a songwriter to the stars.
There's always a song in my head, and it's just never turned off.
This Justin Bieber hit earned James a Grammy nomination at 23.
The music that's been playing inside of me has been heard by, I suppose, millions of people. It's a pretty cool thing.
But away from the studio, his life has been consumed by a secret addiction. James was introduced to porn at just 9 years old.
I remember being shown a video by a friend. It was shocking and exciting, totally unfamiliar. It's like giving a drug to a child. It changed my life forever.
He's part of the first generation that grew up in the age of online porn.
When the internet got faster, I was able to stream it. I had to hide it from my family. There was kind of an adventurous element to it. It just happened to be that the adventure was happening in a world of fantasy and not out in reality.
There's endless amounts of porn. So rather than being a magazine or a video or a set of images, it's a revolving experience that never ends.
Dr. Robert Weiss is one of California's top sex therapists, helping hundreds of young people who've become addicts.
They seem to have gotten hooked on porn at an early age as a replacement for social activities and relational activities.
Watching it releases dopamine, our most powerful pleasure chemical.
Addiction is the misuse of pleasurable experiences to escape. So I can drink to escape, I can gamble to escape, or I can look at porn for 3 or 4 hours.
It becomes your way of coping with any kind of stress, whether it's small or large. Because it's normalized, I didn't feel there was anything wrong with it. You get into a trance, it's like a trance-like state. I could watch 40 different videos. It can go on for so long, it's not even pleasurable. It's a trap, it keeps you hanging on.
But when did porn become so powerful? After all, it's always been part of our culture.
Thirsty has a nice cover which would attract children, but inside it has some of the most disgusting things.
Dirty mags and steamy videotapes, a source of moral panic.
If children are to be brought up with a balanced attitude towards sex, they must be protected from contamination of their minds.
That was then. This is now.
Porn in 2018 is a completely different beast to what it was. This isn't a Playboy or a penthouse under the bed.
David Shanks is the chief censor. His team used to be able to police what came into the country.
All of this material would be restricted R18 at least.
But not anymore.
The internet is the Wild West for porn. There has never been such a powerful, far-reaching platform that's so unregulated. Porn companies today are not really about porn. They're big data companies. So they're competing against the likes of Facebook, Netflix, YouTube. What they're about is getting as many views as possible for as long as possible.
That means their content is becoming more shocking.
I mean, you see how prevalent the trend of incest or the stepsister, stepfather, stepdad, stepmum, which is a very interesting trend specifically for the New Zealand demographic as well.
Porn on the internet is not about making love. There's sites that just focus on degrading, humiliating acts or even promote sexual aggression and rape. It's the last thing that you would want to have young people using as a primary source of education about what sex is.
What age do you think people first see porn?
I remember just in intermediate.
Intermediate, 12 years old.
I was probably 11 or 12.
Probably like 12 or 13, and it's like so young.
At Auckland's Western Springs College, porn is up for discussion.
People aren't actively watching porn to learn about sex. Mm-hmm. They're watching it, and then from that, that's where their sex education is coming from.
The majority of porn is hardcore, too aggressive. It's like completely different to what I guess they try to tell us about in sex ed.
Dr. Weiss says parents shouldn't panic.
Just because everyone drinks doesn't mean everyone's an alcoholic. And just because everyone looks at porn doesn't mean everyone's gonna have a porn problem. However, if you're 15 years old, if you've never seen a naked person, and you're looking at ritualistic, bizarre, or unusual sexual practices over and over again and masturbating to them, it's gonna affect your sex life and it's gonna be a problem.
In his early 20s, porn destroyed James's relationships with every girl he dated.
I wasn't able to deal with the reality of being with somebody. My porn use was creating expectations that were not able to be met by my real life partner.
It also began to affect his body.
We call it PIED, porn-induced erectile dysfunction. Some young people become conditioned to this intense sexual experience online, and that leaves them less able to carry out a real life experience with a person. And it is simply not stimulating enough for them to get aroused.
I felt like a pervert. I've carried around a deep sense of shame for longer than I knew that I even had the shame.
Isn't that sad? There's a young man with lots and lots of promise, and he feels ashamed about who he is.
Tracy Martin is a mother of three and the Minister for Children.
How do you feel about the porn industry?
I feel about them the same way I feel about people who produce other addictive substances. They are in it for the money.
She says porn isn't just harmless fantasy. It actually shapes real-life behaviour.
We're having more young women show up at health services with physical side effects of incredibly rough sex. So tearing, bruising, situations like that. The number of times in this imagery that choking while having sex takes place. And that's happening to our young women.
Now, the minister's planning a crackdown on porn.
Some people will see this as, you know, me trying to take away some of their rights. But on both sides of the camera, there's too many young people at stake here.
Coming up...
Action!
The future of porn from the inside.
The person watching it, it feels like they're in the porn.
And James comes back to the real world.
It's the hardest thing I've ever had to do. But there is a way out.
Everybody.
In the leafy hideaway of the rich and famous, I'm about to go behind the curtain to find out how porn is really made.
Full silence, please. Action!
It's the most amazing job any male would think of, you know. Oh, the best job in the world, right?
At 51, Tommy Gunn is one of America's most prolific porn stars.
How many scenes have you done?
Probably 2,000.
2,000?
I've won every accolade you can win.
Anna Rose has just turned 19. She's been in porn for 6 months.
It's intimidating. I don't know. The first time on set, you have no idea like what you're getting yourself into. Just gotta go for it.
In a $5 million mansion, it's business time for these two strangers.
How is porn sex different to real sex?
I would not even consider it sex.
Do some whispering and some kissing.
On set, you have to do what they want, and that's not always what you want or what the guy wants.
So then how do I initiate doing things if he doesn't talk?
You can act like he's talking. You had to start off so strong. That was perfect.
The positions you wouldn't do in real life, you know? It's not comfortable.
So how do you deal with that when you're being directed to do things that you don't feel comfortable?
You just gotta pretend.
You gotta pretend.
Yep, just gotta act.
Well, porn sex is, it's a performance. It's a staged event. I haven't made love in years.
Really?
Yeah.
A single scene takes hours to film.
1 minute left.
So that was uncomfortable. The girl was stressed. She said she felt awkward. She actually told the director that she was going to pass out at one point, but she was told to just keep going with the scene.
And there's more to this scene than meets the eye. Porn's new frontier is virtual reality, designed for headsets.
The person watching it, it feels like they're in the porn.
So the viewer feels like they're the one having sex with you.
Yep.
Wow. It's scary. What the technology's done is beyond what anybody would have believed.
Our Minister for Children says virtual reality porn poses an even greater threat to young people.
This has arrived so far and so fast that we don't have any systems or safety nets to really counter it.
Tracy Martin knows she can't just ban the internet, but she wants to protect under 18s.
I want to give them the ability to choose and be fully informed before they are bombarded by images that they then, once they see it, they can't unsee it.
The UK is trying to make porn sites use age verification to restrict access to adults only. Critics say that system won't work, but our government is looking at the same options.
If I can do one single thing, I'm going to change the law as quickly as possible.
Meanwhile, our best hope is education, at school and at home.
Parents need to talk to their kids not at 15 when they find the porn on the computer. They need to start talking to their kids at 7, at 9, at 11.
Yeah, I think porn has a massive impact on people because consent is never shown, protection's never shown.
If we want our children to learn that sex has something to do with intimacy or love or relationship or connection, then you're going to have to sit down and tell them that.
Since joining the porn industry earlier this year, Anna Rose has experienced depression. She's now on medication.
You must feel sometimes that you're being used.
Yeah.
That you're being used to sell a commercial product.
No, that definitely happens a lot, but I feel used in real life too. I feel used in real sex also.
Are there times that you kind of go, why am I don't want to be doing this?
All the time, but also at the end of the day, it's like, what else would I do?
For Tommy, porn is also just a day job. He often uses drugs to maintain his erection.
Everyone thinks I've got to be the happiest guy in the world. Well, you know, I'll go home and, you know, I shut the light out at night by myself, so.
That shoot will be edited down and the person watching at home will have no idea how long it took to make
or how unreal, unsexy the whole process was.
It seems neither the porn stars nor the porn users are truly satisfied.
I was using it to deal with pain.
Please don't give up on me.
Despite all his success, James's life has often felt empty.
For as long as I can remember, I felt like I was on the outside. I don't really know what I'm doing. I don't know how I got here.
Porn allowed him to escape those uncomfortable feelings, but it came at a cost.
Using porn was turning me into a sex addict. All I wanted was to just have sex, no matter how I got it. Whether it was using Tinder to hook up, whether it was paying for sex. And I thought, geez, where's your self-respect?
At rock bottom, James asked for help from a sex therapist.
It's the hardest thing I've ever had to do, because I'm trying to undo something that I've been doing my whole life. But there is a way out.
I get nervous thinking about cooking for you guys, because it's like...
In the simplest terms, the antidote to porn addiction is connection. It's reconnecting that person with pleasurable experiences with people. Pleasure like hanging out with friends, pleasure like being on a team, pleasure like dating, pleasure like sex with a partner. The more you introduce that person and push them toward connection, the less interested they're going to be in the porn.
That's the whole point of why I do what I do.
Before there was social anxiety, before there was the fear that I wouldn't be accepted. But now I don't have to feel like I'm hiding something anymore.
Instead, he's using music to tell his story.
This song was about my addiction.
Striking a chord with pop's biggest stars.
When I saw Demi Lovato perform my song, it brought me to tears.
Don't do it for me anymore.
When I was able to give up my porn use, I started to notice the beauty again. I started to realize that, oh, this is what life is supposed to be like. I want to be loved, and I want to be able to love someone else.
For now, he's just focused on being comfortable in his own skin.
I'm starting to get to know myself, and I'm not so bad.
Isn't he impressive? Very brave. A new Kiwi website has tools for parents on how to talk to your kids about porn. Go to thelightproject.co.nz. And if this story has raised issues for you, please talk to a health professional.